So let's postpone it till tomorrow. Bishri has some, come on now. You have only one page in your hand.
Only some here. Assalamu alaikum. I have got some here. Because I was allowed to ask one question, that's why I should have one in my hand.
Okay. Come to the microphone now and then to one side. Yes.
Would Hazur advise us?
Slightly shift to the left hand. Okay, that's okay.
Would Hazur advise us how we should answer in short when those people not believing in the existence of Allah Ta'ala who say we have everything we need, for example health, wealth, televisions, houses, cars and other things. Why should we believe in Allah Ta'ala and pray to Him?
How can you answer them in short when you can't even ask in short? A person who cannot ask a question in short, I can't conceive him to give a short answer to anybody. So you are putting me in a great difficulty.
My first one after two questions, so I thought that the time may be
sufficient. No, I am not objecting. What I am saying is that your question is impossible for me to answer. You want me to tell you a shortcut to give a short answer to a very big and important question. While you generally make very long queries. Your questions are longish. How can you make short answer? This I can't know. I mean, I don't know any method, any magic by which I can make you give a short answer and that too very satisfactorily.
Hazur, I knew this subject is very vast, but I wanted to, Hazur can make a brief comment.
I can't make it, turn this vast subject into, I mean, can't force it into a small space. It's impossible. The fact is, I understand your point, but you, I'm not just whiling away the time, I mean it by what I say. The fact is that the question of the evidence of the existence of God is a very vast subject, applies to a very vast subject, and the people who are agnostics or atheistics, they belong to different categories. And not only the categories differ, but individuals belonging to a certain category also differ. So not knowing whom I am addressing, I can't give you a short answer which would be applicable to any question. Some people have a scientific mind and you can approach them scientifically. Some people have inherited a sort of philosophy and they only want an answer in terms of that philosophy. For instance, the philosophy of scientific socialism. Their arguments against the existence of God revolve around a certain fundamental point and they are very sensitive to this issue because if they begin to believe in God, their whole philosophy goes overboard. So they always object to the existence of God with a certain philosophy in mind. Similarly, there are agnostics of so many types who say we don't know. And to give them a short, brief argument and suddenly they begin to know, this is not possible. You have first to go a few steps along with them. You hear them on the subject and tell them to explain what their views are. What objection do they have? Or do they have any objection or just it is lack of knowledge. All these things have to be discussed with a person before you find out the right way of answering such a person or satisfying such a person. It is not possible, in fact, to give a short answer. Hazrat Muslim Aw, for instance, I remember, whenever was approached by an atheist or agnostic, he would go along with him a few steps and discuss things of what was his view and what he thought and what sort of evidence would he require. For instance, once a Sikh came to him who was an agnostic and who had a very long discussion with him in Masjid Mubarak, and Hazrat, he said, "I want the proof of the existence of God in a manner that he should punish me and show me his wrath." So Hazrat Muslim Aw took a very long time trying to convince him that he can be also seen in a better way. Why don't you demand his mercy and his beneficence and a sign of his nearness so that I pray and you see the sign? So Sardarji insisted, "No, no, no. I want some punishment." So it all depends. A sign of benevolence, a sign of mercy and kindness was meaningless to him. So if I say, I start talking of such a sign and the person whom you are addressing or whom you want to address is built after that Sardarji, how will this work on him? And if I give you a sign of a different nature like for Lake Ram and this and that, and the person you are addressing is brought up in a different social setup and he is horrified with such a God, with the concept of such a God, he wants some benign manifestation, so that argument would become meaningless to him. And there are some who are just logical people, who want a logical argument. So to them, both these arguments would be meaningless. So I can count on and on such varieties of people who should be treated individually. I mean, I can't write a book here at this moment. You see, so you are also an individual. You have a special mind and a special thing in your mind. So give this allowance to everybody else as well. Although I was addressing you, I tried to satisfy you, yet it seems that I was all around you but not at you. And something I missed, despite the fact that I already know you so much. So how can my answer satisfy someone whom I do not know at all? Now you come and explain yourself, please.
No, look, when I start thinking of this question, I knew this is a very vast subject and would not fit in this small time. But what I wanted was everyday life. We come across, and suppose we stop in the street and meet some friends or old friends and all this, and we talk to them. Oh, they know we are religious. And we start talking to them. And
they don't believe in God.
No, some of them may not. And in a joking way, they say, "Oh, we have got everything. Why you talk about God at all?"
It's like if you claim you want to draw up an argument, we should clinch the whole
issue. We know them, and we can pursue them after, we can continue them after that. But I want you to know when they say, "Oh, we have got everything, we are all being with it, why you bother us to believe in God and pray to Him?"
Don't answer. Rectify your approach. That means your approach is totally wrong. You are trying to enter a building not through the door, but through a thick wall. Find the door. Everybody is built differently. He has his own plan of things. And he is provided with some doors and windows and places of entrance and also walls to protect the house. So whenever you don't know the plan of a house, you make such mistakes.